I know after the election many of us felt deflated, not necessarily because one party had won or lost, but because the party that won had no credible climate policy.
The vested interests in the fossil fuel industry have endless dollars to spend. In Australia, we've seen Clive Palmer put $60 million into trying to mislead people in Queensland.
That's more than the whole of the climate movement has to spend annually, and it's more than 15 times the budget of the Climate Council.
I think the election outcome was very disappointing, but I don't believe that Australians voted for a lack of action on climate change.
The majority of Australians now believe that this is a big issue. They want to see action. They understand that renewable energy is one of the key solutions, and they're looking for action at all levels of government, from the federal to state and local levels. But it's not enough.
We're really going to scale up our work here at the Climate Council, provided we get the support.
In the last month, I've been pondering what is our plan going forward. And what I keep coming back to is we need to scale up our activities. We need to do more and we need to do it better. The plan going forward is four things. The first is to support those on the ground that are already doing things. So local governments, state governments, businesses, community groups that are already taking action. The second is to put unrelenting pressure on the federal government to take action. The third, ensure that we're continuing to put climate change at the top of the agenda through media work, through our reports, etc. And the fourth is to bring new voices into the climate space, like emergency services, doctors, farmers, who can help reach new audiences.
Look, Climate Council supporters are all leaders on climate change. And the one thing I would say to you all is just continue leading.
I want to thank all of the Climate Council donors. Thousands of people giving roughly $30 a month allow us to do all of our critical work.
You know, if you've ever considered getting behind Australia's people-powered Climate Council, now's the time to do it.
So now it's over to you. Thank you.